Piranha 2, The Spawning, is James Cameron's first full-length feature that he's directed. He's criticized it several times and gone on record saying he wants his name removed from the project. But hey, this movie stars Lance Hendrickson, and with a team like that, how could you go wrong? Well, the executive producer's name is Asinitis, so we're off to a good start. Before the opening credits, we have our first kill. A couple are diving down to a shipwreck, and they get attacked and killed by the piranhas. Next, we meet Chris and his mother, Anne. Anne works at the resort as a diving instructor, and they get their room for free. Gabby and his son are out fishing in the water with dynamite. The police officer, Steven, and Chris's father stops by and threatens them. But it's just a joke. Gabby and Steve go way back and are pretty good friends. Chris gets invited to go sailing with some rich dude. He agrees, mainly because of his daughter. Anne explains the spawning. The fish come up from the ocean to the beach, where the guests can grab the fish and cook them. This happens every year at the first full moon after the spring equinox. Anne takes some tourists out to a dive, but she warns them to not go in the shipwreck. Well, of course, one of the guys doesn't listen, and he goes right in. Anne goes after him and finds him dead. One of the guests, Tyler, is really trying to get into Anne's pants, so they sneak into the morgue together. Anne needs to know what killed that diver because she feels responsible. She takes some pictures, but they get caught by a nurse. They run out of there pretty quick, and the nurse has to clean up their mess. She's taking care of the body, and a piranha comes out of it. It jumps at her and kills her, then flies out the window. They still don't know 100% what is killing everyone, but Anne suspects piranhas, even though they can't live in the ocean. She dives down to the shipwreck and confirms it is the killer fish. We also find out Tyler knows more about it. He's a biochemist that worked on the project for the government. He came here because of the shipwreck. There were genetically modified piranhas on it that can live in fresh water, salt water, and they can even fly. In the night, Chris and the daughter have snuck away to an island. They try to get back to the boat, but get lost at sea. Meanwhile, Gabby's son gets attacked and killed. He finds his son, and it's a pretty sad scene. This motivates him to kill all the fish. He takes out all the dynamite he has and makes a bomb. It's finally the night of the big spawning festival, and everyone is lined up at the beach. They start pounding on drums to attract the fish, and the ocean comes alive. Just as people start to run to catch them, the flying piranhas attack. Everyone moves inside, but Gabby tries to take them one at a time. He can't put up much of a fight, however, and is overtaken by the flying fish. Deciding to put the matter into their own hands, Anne and Tyler set up the bomb underwater. They have just 20 minutes to get out of there, but the piranhas have them cornered. Meanwhile, Chris and his girlfriend are right in the blast zone, and his dad has to rescue him. He ditches the helicopter, and they all board onto a boat. Steven knows Anne and Tyler are in the wreckage, and he's waiting on them, but he also knows the bomb will blow up at 6:30. Back in the wreckage, they're using the ship's vents to get around safely. However, Tyler gets stuck, and the piranhas break in. They attack and kill Tyler, allowing Anne to get out of there. But it's 6:29, and Steven has to start the boat to get him and his son to safety. Anne grabs onto the anchor and is pulled away just as the piranhas all blow up. And that's Piranha 2, The Spawning. It's not a bad movie, it's definitely watchable, but there are plenty of other things I can think to do with my time. The flying fish idea is pretty dumb. No amount of genetic engineering can make a fish breathe out of water, let alone fly. In the first movie, they made it so if you even touched the water, you were in danger. Here, they dive into the fish's home and don't even get bit most of the time. Most of this movie was filmed underwater, and I know James Cameron is big into diving, so I guess that makes sense. But speaking of Cameron, when he went to the screening of this movie in Rome, he spent all of his money on the plane ticket and couldn't even afford to eat. Due to exhaustion and malnutrition, he got sick with a fever, and that night, he had a nightmare about a metallic torso emerging up from an explosion and dragging itself over the floor. Does that sound familiar? So, yeah, if it wasn't for this movie, we wouldn't have The Terminator. I give Piranha 2, The Spawning, 2 Asinitis out of 4.
This sweet little fish called a grunion swims up out of the ocean onto the beach for a moment of privacy for his mating ritual. And the human beings swoop down on him, scoop him up, and fry him for dinner.
But how do you know it's tomorrow night?
It's always the first full moon after the spring equinox.
Oh. But how do the fish know?